Hi, I'm Mike Massimino, and this is Inside the International Space Station.
Well, not really. A 100 camels running around. It's a Dreamliner, 787.
And we're going to talk with Joe Acaba and Suni Williams about their upcoming space flight.
It's a nice thing for people to learn a little bit more about a different culture and a different part of the planet. Even Kazakhstan, even Baikonur itself was secret to the Russians for a long time, for
really?
Most of the Russian public, right? Yeah.
Okay.
In the last, you know, couple decades, it's sort of, you know, of course, now everybody knows where Baikonur is. But I mean, it's an amazing history. It's out in the middle of nowhere. We launch in Florida, of course, so all the pieces can fall in the ocean. They launch in Kazakhstan because, you know, east of that is just the steppe. But the big pieces still fall in the steppe. And
the steppe is, I'm sorry, what is that?
This big desert-type brush area
running
east of where Baikonur is.
Okay.
So the big rocket pieces, the first stage, all falls back on the land. The second stage all falls back on the land. And they did that so nobody would actually really know. It was, of course, the Soviet Union. Nobody would actually know where their launch pad was or what they were doing from the very beginning. But so it's cool now that TV cameras are coming to that place and they're seeing it. When I was there last time, we saw a herd of camels, you know, like 100 camels running around, wild horses. It is in the middle of freaking nowhere.
Yeah.
And they made it that way on purpose. And they actually, the name Baikonur was spelled a little bit wrong, so people didn't know exactly where it was on the map when they first settled it. So the history is pretty cool, and it's neat for, I think, other folks in the U.S., and I hope there's more news people who come to Kazakhstan so they could understand the whole history of the space program. It wasn't just ours. Ours was awesome, of course, going to the moon and everything leading up to it, but theirs too, and the effort that the Soviet Union and the Russians made is pretty historic, and it's nice to be able to share that. It's another appreciation for different cultures. It's cool.
So that Baikonur is where Sputnik was launched from, and Yuri Gagarin.
Uh-oh, now you're going to ask me stuff I don't know.
Yuri don't was, yeah.
Yuri, for sure, but I don't know about Sputnik. Yeah.
And it was secret. So how do you get in there on a C-130 or something? How do you get to this place? When you go to Russia.
It's a Dreamliner, 787. It's all luxury.
So you, when you
far
go
from
to,
it, my friend.
So when you go to Russia, you fly into Moscow. When you guys go there, and then you train in Star City,
right.
And then you go off to Baikonur, which you fly to this place.
Is yeah. That,
you can't tell me where. You can't tell me where it is.
It's secret still.
Right.
I don't know where it is. No.
So you fly in there. There's obviously a runway there in a small town, or.
Yeah, actually, Baikonur is a closed city. It's a little interesting place because we have to have, of course, your passport when you're leaving Russia to go, I guess, through Kazakhstan. But Baikonur, actually, the airport might be in Kazakhstan. The airport's in Kazakhstan, so you need your passport and your papers to get into Kazakhstan by landing at the airport, Kryiny, I think it's called. And then they drive you into Baikonur, the town, which is a closed town. It's sort of like an embassy because it's a town. I think
like
it was
Vatican
like
or something.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, and within this,
it's its own little thing, which is Russian. And then we stay and we live in this little town called Baikonur. But actually, I think I read it was home to like 100,000 people at one point in time at the height of the space program. So it's not tiny.
But
it's a town.
It's a space town.
It's a space town.
Rocket city.
Rocket city, exactly.
and the spaceships and rockets are built other places and then shipped over there and assembled and shot off from
the Cosmodrome.
Cosmodrome.
It sounds so cool, doesn't it?
Cosmodrome.
Cosmodrome.
Cosmodrome. Sounds like an Olympic venue.
Exactly.
And that's where the Progress launches from the same place and all their stuff that they want. It's all.
They have a couple different places, but that's the main place, from what I've heard.
Okay.
Yeah, they have a pretty big train station right in the center of town, and I think that was built. And again, I don't quote me on all the historic points here because I don't want to screw
Please.
It up too bad.
Yeah.
I saw this movie, Belka and Strelka. It's a cartoon about those dogs, and I believe everything that it said. But there's a pretty big railway system that goes to that town, and that's how the people originally got there. They actually lived in tents. Remember from we do this really cool, as a backup crew member, you get to go to the museum there and you see a little bit of the history of the town. So that's where I'm grabbing some of this from, but the folks who lived there originally when they were building the town, they lived in tents. And this is, again, like I said, out in the middle of nowhere. And they created this whole cosmodrome, spaceport, and the town while they're out there. So it's pretty neat. But most of the pieces are made in different places. Our Soyuz is made in outside of Moscow at a company named Energia. And the rocket parts are from a company or a town in Samara, which I think is also close to Moscow. And then all those pieces are trained down, on the train down. Yeah.